Hello, hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing good. As for me, I am doing fantastic. My name is Nati and I welcome you to Manchi Teaches You, hashtag Manchi Teacher Hub. I hope you guys you are writing well with your exams, hey? So I would really like to thank my subscribers. Guys, thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing. Thank you for liking. Thank you very much. And I wish to welcome those who are joining us for the first time. Guys, welcome. Take a seat wherever you want to sit. Feel free to ask questions if you have any. And those are always joining us, guys. Thank you very much. Thank you. I really, really appreciate. And also, guys, if you want me to assist you with your CV, it's 50 rand. It goes hand in hand with cover letter, so which means your CV and cover letter is 50 rand, and if you want me to assist you with the assignment, it's 150. If you want me to assist you one-on-one with maybe computer practice, communication, it's 200. So if you want me to assist you in those three things, please don't be afraid to go in the comment section and ask that, can you please help me, okay? Without wasting much of your time, guys, today we're going to do communication and for June 2021. I don't think it's too much. It's just small, okay? So as you can see here, it's 9 to 11. I always say, guys, read the instruction. It's very, very important, okay? So the instruction state, answer all the questions. Read all the questions carefully. I love this one, guys. Take note of it. Start each section on a new page. It's very, very important. So our first section is basic communication principles. Question one, it says, list and briefly explain 6 different elements of communication process. We know that we have communication process. So you have to list. After listing, you briefly explain, okay? So the first one, we have a sender, and the explanation is the person who communicates or send and encodes the message or information. Then the second one, we have message. The explanation, it's the information that is sent to the receiver. Then we have receiver, the person who receives and decodes the message information. Then we have medium, the channel used to send the message. For example, it can be verbal, telephone, or letter. Then we have feedback, the response or reaction of the receiver to the message. It can be conscious or unconscious, positive or negative, direct or indirect, verbal or non-verbal. That is your what? Your feedback. Then we have barrier, also known as interference, can occur at any time in the process, will cause a breakdown in communication. So those are 6 different elements of the communication person. Is the sender the person who's sending the message or the information, or is the one who is starting to communicate? Then we have the message. What is the person saying? Then we have the receiver, the person who is listening. Then we have the medium. What is that person using? It can be a telephone, it can be a message, it can be a WhatsApp. Then a feedback, which means a feedback from what? From the receiver. It can be through reaction, it can be through answering, you know, such things. Then we have a barrier. While sending a message or while communicating with someone, there can be a barrier in between. It's either, let's say, for example, you are communicating with someone through WhatsApp, the barrier, it can be what? Network. That is what? A barrier. Or you are communicating with someone face to face, then you hear a loud track passing by and the receiver couldn't receive or understand what you're saying. That's what? A loud noise. It's a what? It's a barrier. So we have different barriers. We have internal barrier and external barrier. But today we are not on that one. Okay, next time. So back to the question paper. 1.2, identify the main factor that will influence communication in each of the scenario. Influence communication, main factors, which means you have to know the factors that influence communication. Okay, the first one says, Mashego cannot understand why her boss is so difficult. In her culture, a funeral takes many days. Her grandmother has recently passed away and her family is expecting her to come home. She needs to put in leave for at least 4 days, and yet her boss is only granting her only 1 day's leave. So what is the factor there? The factor is frame of reference or cultural differences. We all know that we have different cultures. Some cultures, they don't bury a person for, like, they don't wait the whole week. Only if a person dies today, tomorrow they're burying that person. And the following day, they are back to work. So that one is frame of reference or cultural difference. Then we go to 1.2.2. Musa does not understand why his new colleague is so quiet and reserved, and decided that she must be a snob. The way how you see a person. Some people, they are quiet. Some people, they don't like talking, you know. And some people, they misinterpret that person and say, nah, that person's a snob. So what is the factor then? The factor is what? It's reasoning. The factor is reasoning. Then we go to 3. Leroy cannot wait for the weekend to pass because he simply loves his job. He's always upbeat and positive. The factor there is what? It's personality. Then we have the 4th one. Kate has fetching her children from their dancing lesson every day afternoon. The traffic is bad, dinner is always an issue, and she never feels appreciated. What factor is that? It's emotions. Emotions. Then we go to 1.3. Various options are given as possible answers to the following questions. Choose the answer and write only the letter A to D next to the question number in the answer book, which means you're only writing the question number and then the letter next to it. Communication refers to communication that takes place between two or more individuals. Your answer there is interpersonal. Interpersonal is a communication between two or more individuals. Then the second one refers to the communication of message by means of what? Of body movement. Your answer there is kinesics. B, kinesics. Okay. Then we go to the third one. The third one says a distance of 2 meters is maintained during communication in the zone. Zone. It's what? It's social. Social, number D. It's social. Then number 4, the lecturer spoke so quickly during her presentation that many of the students left the class confused. This is caused by her. Your answer there is what? It's tempo and rhythm. Tempo and rhythm. Number 5, telephone conversation are examples of indirect verbal communication. Indirect verbal communication. Then we go to number 1.4. Give a clear definition of each of the following concepts. We have visual semiology. Visual semiology. Communication that depends on the receiver's sense of sight. Communication that depends on the receiver's sense of sight. That is visual semiology. Then we have acoustic semiology. Acoustic It's your sense of hearing to get a message from Satan's sounds or signals other than language. That's your acoustic semiology. Then we have filler sounds. Filler sounds such as wow, ah, ah. You know, whenever we're talking like, those ones are called filler sounds. That indicates uncertainty, interest, shock, or sympathy. Then we have tarsesix, communication by means of touch that can be used to convey a message, but in the workplace could be easily misunderstood and lead to charges of sexual harassment. Okay. Then we go to fatigue communication. This shows general sociability or manners rather than contributing to the content or meaning in the conversation. Then we go to 1.5. It says, list three types of listening and briefly discuss each. Okay, list three. We have attentive listening. Attentive listening. Then it says, listening to identify the speaker's main point and the concentrating on how it can benefit you. That is attentive listening. Then we have critical listening. Critical listening, determining the aim of the message, analyzing how it is put across and whether it is achieving its purpose. If a point is not clear, ask for it to be repeated. If you are to make a truly objective assessment of what of the conversation, that is called critical listening. Then we have appreciative listening. Appreciative listening. This is key to understanding what is being said and then reacting to it. Don't react to the differences of culture, personality, or opinion. And don't interrupt the speaker. It's very, very rude. Okay? So, we are done with section A, which is 40 marks. Then we go to section B, which is interpersonal relationships and social interaction. Question 2.1 is, it is important to be able to identify characteristics of a good or weak self-image. Specific behavior is associated with different characteristics. Indicate whether the following behaviors are negative or positive by writing only positive or negative. Number one, it's autocratic. Autocratic, it's negative. Number two, biased. Biased, it's what? It's negative. Number three, moderate. Moderate, it's positive. Number four, contented. Contented, it's positive. Number five, opinionated. Opinionated, it's negative. Then 2.2 says, in 1943, the psychologist Abraham Harold Maslow described how he saw the different level of people's needs. Sketch Maslow's interpretation of these needs. I did draw it. I hope you guys will see it. It's like this. You see? This is physical. This is safety. This is social. This is esteem. This is self-actualization, which means I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have to number them going upwards. Okay. Then 2.3 says, define self-image. Self-image, one's idea of what one is. One's idea of what one is. 2.4, what are the three elements of self-image? We have what you think of yourself. The second one, what you think other people think of you.
Number three, what you would like your image to be.
Then we go to 2.5. You're going to choose your answer in column B. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to read column A and give you the answer in column B. So the first one is a perceptual barrier. Your answer there is what? It's G. When people differ in their perceptions based on different values, attitudes, and backgrounds. Number two, physiological barrier. Your answer is E. Sender or receiver state of health prevents the message from being received clearly. Number three, semantic barrier. Your answer here is A. Sender and receiver attach different meaning to a certain word, the language itself becoming a barrier. Number four, secondary reference group. Your answer is H. People with whom you have indirect contact. Then number five, ethnocentricity. Your answer there is K. Person from a certain group, nation, or culture regards himself or herself as a superior to others. Number six, gatekeeping. Gatekeeping, your answer there is I. Deliberate creation of communication barriers. Number seven, prejudice. Your answer there is C. Making up your mind about someone or something without proper knowledge. Number eight, primary reference group. Your answer there is B. People with whom you have direct contact, close relationship, which are personal. Number nine, physical barrier. Your answer there is J. Interference such as noisy traffic, which prevents the message from being understood. Number 10, education barrier. Your answer there is D. The sender and receiver have different levels of what? Of knowledge and intelligence. Those are your answers. Then section B is 30. Then we go to what? To organizational communication. Organizational communication. Question 3. Mr. Ramon Nake is the managing director of CJ System. Three managers report to him, one each in charge of sales, marketing, and media relations, respectively, supervisors directly responsible for staff in each department report to their managers. Draw an organogram to illustrate the line organization of CJ System. Okay, I have already drawn it up, so it's like this. This is the manager. Okay, and these are this is the managing director, and these are managers. This is the managing director. This one, it's a managing director. And these are managers, okay? And these are supervisors, and these are staff. Which means staff report directly to what? To the supervisor. Supervisor report what? To the manager. Manager report what? To manager, managing director. So this is your organogram, okay? So here you're just going to write manager director, which means you are going to say Mr. Ramon Nake. And here you're going to say sales department. Then you put what? You put manager, just like that. Okay. Then we go to section D, interviews. Question 4. Identify the type of question asked by the interviewee in each of the following examples. You must know your interviews. Okay. You must know the type of interviews. Okay, so the first one says,
Why do you think working for this company will help you realize your potential? What kind of question is that? It is an open-ended. Open-ended. Then the second one, you say you enjoy working with people. Could you please explain why you say so? The second one is what is reflective. Your answer there is what? Reflective. Then the third, it says, if we were to offer you an unlimited budget, how would you improve our market strategies? Your answer there is hypothetical. 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 Number four, this is a business with a very conservative way of doing things. Do you think it is time to change? That one is leading. Leading. Then do you have, when could you start work? Number five, that is closed question. Closed question. And when do you have a car of your own? That is also a closed question. So it's very important to know what the type of questions. Okay, you must know the what type of interviews, because I'm sure it will come, and also the type of questions. Okay, like here, it says, what is the definition of disciplinary interview? Know the interviews and type of questions. So your answer there, it is a pre-planned, confidential, formal oral conversation between the employee and the employer to persuade the employee to change his or her behavior to become an effective employee again. Okay, that's the disciplinary interview. Understanding the difference between assertive and aggressive behavior in any interview, it is very important. 4.3.1. Explain the difference between assertiveness and aggressiveness. Assertive. You state your case honestly, clearly, logically, politely, without anger. And also, you can offer constructive suggestion. While aggressive, you do not consider the feeling or rights of others. And also, your behavior is destructive. Okay? Then 4.3.2 says, is the following statement assertive or aggressive? How was I supposed to know what is written in your stupid policy? It's what? Aggressiveness. Aggressive. Then the following one, 4.3.3, is the following statement assertive or aggressive? I truly regret what happened. My sincere apologies. That is assertive. The fourth one says, is the following statement assertive or aggressive? You are always victimizing me. That is what? Aggressive. That is what? Aggressive. Then we go to 4.4. If you are the interviewee, list three things you could do after a job interview to ensure that the interviewer sees you in a positive light and to ensure that you make the right choice should you be offered a job. The first one, thank the interviewer for giving you the opportunity. The second one, evaluate all the information you received at the interview and decide if you really want to work for the company. The third one, write a formal letter of thanks to the interviewer. If you get the job, write a letter to either decline or accept their position. Then we go to section E, meeting terminology, question 5. Choose a description that matches term. So which means this is your description and these are matching term. Okay. Motion, your answer there is C. Formal suggestion or proposal for something to be done. It can be accepted or rejected. Number two, proposal. Your answer is G. Formal suggestion or proposal for something to be done. Number three, closure. Your answer is H. Meeting is declared officially closed and all items on the agenda have been discussed. Number four, adjourn. Your answer is E. to end a meeting with the intention of resuming it later if a meeting runs out of time. And the last one, ad hoc committee. Ad hoc committee. It's what a committee that is formed for a specific purpose and then dissolved. Dissolved. So we are done for today. We are done with communication and four. I hope it will assist someone. And I wish you all the luck. From me to you, I say bye. See you next time.